Sino sini? Something politics. Okay, good evening everyone and welcome to the show. Okay, I am given only 20 minutes and I will not waste my time talking about my past. But revisiting the Malaysia Agreement, we are actually talking about the past. And I wonder how many of you have visited the Malaysia Agreement in your lifetime. Maybe once, even once, maybe twice. I have been visiting the Malaysia Agreement almost every day. Because I keep seeing things happening different from what has been written. That's why I entitled my talk, Malaysia Agreement, Dissolve or Resolve? Solve or Dissolve? We have to solve the problems that are facing the Malaysia Agreement. Now, before we go into that, why was Malaysia formed? Why was Malaysia formed? And we know Malaysia was formed for different reasons to different components. I mean, Britain had its own agenda, to consolidate its empire after the war. Malaya, of course, the Federation of Malaya had its own agenda. For example, the issue of security with communism and the merger with Singapore. What about Sabah and Sarawak? We simply got dragged into it. We got dragged into it because we were part of the British Empire. And at that time, we were not even ready. According to the Cobalt Commission, Sabah needs another 20 years before it's ready to be given independence, what more to be merged with, to be put into a merger, but they don't know anything about. The same thing with Sarawak, but Sarawak is much more politically mature, it only requires another 10 years. So for Sabah, we could have been ready only in 1983. That was 30 years ago. Not 51 years ago. So, why we got dragged in, you now know, we don't know the reason. The only reason is that we got dragged in because we have to resolve Malaya and Britain had to resolve the Singapore. When and how was this to be accomplished? How was Malaysia to be accomplished? In the beginning, Tunku Abdul Rahman actually spoke of enlarging the Federation. When Brunei, Sarawak, who were more politically mature than Sabah or North Borneo at the time, heard about it, they immediately rejected. They say, if we were to be part of Malaya, we would be dominated. Whatever we have will be taken over, including our political power, our administration, and so on. So they rejected. And what most of you didn't know was that these three British colonies, Sabah, Sarawak, and Brunei, actually wrote a memorandum to protest against Malaysia, saying that we want independence first. Give us independence first, and later we will consider how this Malaysia project can be part of us. They wrote a memorandum on the 9th of September 1962. Why did they reject Malaysia at the time? Because when Malaysia was being formed, number one, they said is we are being rushed. Second, there is no process of self-determination. If we are going to be to form a federation, it has to be on our terms. What happened? They were labeled as traitors and communists, and they were arrested. And the appointment to present their case to the United Nations was actually abandoned. Why? Because before they could go to the United Nations, Britain already instigated an uprising in Brunei that spread into Lima and Sarawak. Fortunately, not in Sabah. Now, that was the proposal for Malaya expansion, rejected. So, what they did next was to propose a merger of equal partnership. Okay? And equal partnership, meaning that for Sabah and Sarawak, they would get independence. Whether through Malaysia or independently, whether alone or together with Sarawak. These are all documented. And they will be given security. Because they say communism is, you know, the domino effect. Communism is going down from the North China down to Thailand and eventually to Singapore, and communists have already had its presence in Sarawak. So security was one of the basic considerations for Sabah. And for Sabah and Sarawak, because they did not see any more option, because they were still colonies at the time, they had to listen to the British. And according to the record, the Hansard record, in the Legislative Council, there was a decision, they resolved on the 8th of August 1962, or 1963, the Legislative Council resolved to accept the decision of the United Kingdom and Malaya to establish Malaysia. So you see, to accept means they have to accept lah. It was not their decision. They had to accept the decision of Britain and Malaya to form Malaysia, provided that the terms of the agreement will be, the terms of the agreement will include protection of the rights of Sabah and Sarawak. Okay? And so, these terms were eventually expanded and included the political leaders to be called the 20 points. 20 points. 20 points actually, as most people are talking about it, 20 points agreement actually is a memorandum. It's a precondition. Condition for Sabah, for Sarawak, 18 points, before they proceeded to agree to move forward to establish the terms of the agreement. So, in a sense, it is an agreement. Why? Because it's part of the process. I was actually asked when I was under detention whether the 20 points is legal. I was asked one of the questions. So I said, yes, to us it is legal. Why do I consider it as legal? Because it is a precondition. Second, it is included in the IGC to say that whatever is not included in this agreement, but in the form of letters of correspondence and memorandum, will be considered part and parcel of this agreement. So that means it's part of the agreement, right? And so when it was agreed to proceed to protect our rights, we were also to make sure that it is a merger. We were told it's going to be a merger of equal partnership. And this was stated so by no other person than the chairman of the Cobalt Commission, Lord Cobalt, who said that it is to be understood right from the beginning that this is a merger, it's a merger of partnership of nations. You can find it actually. Okay, it's a merger of partnership. And the second part of his portion was that it should not be a takeover. And if there is any idea that Malaysia will be a takeover project, a takeover of the North Borneo and Sarawak, and the submersion of the individual is, it will not work. This is what he said. So, the leaders of Sabah believe that this will be part and parcel of the concept of Malaysia. So what happened today? What happened today, if you look at the reality, is completely different. When it came to the agreement, the Malaysia agreement itself contradict what Tunku Abdul Rahman said when he said that what maybe you can find it. I have 60-70 slides there. But he said, in simple terms, he said, what you will gain from this project, this association, is number one, self-government. And through Malaysia, absolute independence. I also wonder why he used the word absolute independence. Is there such a thing when you federate? If you examine the Malaysia agreement itself, right at the beginning, it says the colonies of North Borneo, Sarawak, and so on, will be federated with the existing state of Malaya. And yet, the proclamation of nation says that Singapore, North Borneo, and Sarawak will be federated with the Federation of Malaya, which are two different things, isn't it? One says with the state, the other says with the Federation of Malaya. And therefore, according to my understanding, and if guided by the document, the British document that was recently released, it says that the ultimate objective of Malaysia is to form a confederation. A confederation among Federation of Malaya, Singapore, Brunei, Sarawak, and Sabah. Now what happened? When it says confederation, it means I see a two-tier federation. Malaya, North Borneo, Sarawak, and Singapore. And then a federal structure at the top. And then under Malaya are all the other states. What happened, actually, this is what happened. Malaya converted itself to become Malaysia, the federal government of Malaysia. And Sabah and Sarawak became the two states, the 13 states, said the Singapore. And so what happened is that we became just one of the states in Malaya. As good as that, it goes back to the original concept that was proposed by Tunku Abdul Rahman. Now, there are so many things that happened later on. What happened? Sabah and Sarawak were downgraded. They changed, they re-engineered the population of Sabah through Project IC. I have a lot of statistics to show you, but maybe question answer section, we will do that. Next, what happened? They play around with our constitution. They introduced the rotation of the chief minister, disregarding our own constitution. Next, what happened? They make it taboo to raise the 20 points, questioning the Malaysia agreement. I became a victim of that when I raised 20 points in the 1980s, 1987 to be exact. And what happened? The Prime Minister at the time, Dr. Mahathir, told me, Jeffrey, don't teach the people what they don't know. That was the attitude of Kuala Lumpur leaders, and this was indicated by the Prime Minister. When I was in detention, another inspector told me not to teach history. Don't teach people history, he said, or you will be nipped in the bud. And I was thinking, isn't that our duty to teach, what they don't know? What more history? So we know that that is the attitude. They want to hide the truth. Today we have problems because apart from downgrading Sabah and Sarawak, they changed the population structure. Today there are 1.7 million foreigners who have the IC compared to 1.5 million locals. In other words, there are more Project IC people than us. How do we, correct this problem? Because those given ICs are those people from southern Philippines, mostly, who were rebelling against their government. Not only given IC, they gave them guns. The Malaysian government give them guns, give them money, give them IC, give them refuge. Today we find kidnappings here and there. Today they intrude into our territories, bringing the guns we have given them. And they have ISIS. Some of them were buried in my constituency. So how do you protect? Where is the promise of security? You guard the border, but they are inside. There's no point. There was a joke saying they have come in one boat, five people. And and our Navy said, where are you going? We need to take Sabah. And he said, only five of you? Yes, because we have thousands already inside. And this is a fact. So what happened today? Not only the Project IC, they also took our oil and gas and a very unusual circumstances, and we don't agree the way they have taken our resources, because constitutionally this is wrong, because we have divisions of responsibility on the state list, federal list, control list, and land and natural resources happen to be on the state list. How could you reach a state?